Then stomatitis. What may be this? At least you speak, na? What is that stomatitis? Inflammation of? Yes, stomatitis, this is the inflammation of oral cavity, okay? This is not inflammation of stomach. Okay, this is inflammation of oral cavity, stomatitis. Okay, so stoma is meaning of stoma is mouth. Okay, so stomatitis. So dermatitis, so inflammation of? What is that? Inflammation of skin. Gastritis, inflammation of stomach. Cystitis, inflammation of urinary bladder. Okay, so they are itis. If there is the itis suffix in the end of the word, that denotes the inflammation of that particular organ. Okay, appendix is the organ. If there is the appendicitis, itis suffix at the end, so this is the inflammation of appendix. Tonsil, you can see the tonsil. Okay, in the oral cavity, we will see the tonsil here on the pharynx. So if the inflammation of the tonsil, so that is the tonsillitis. Okay, sinus, inflammation sinusitis, like that. So see next, that is the suffix ictomy. So if suffix ictomy is there at the end of the word, means that is the complete removal of that organ. Completely you are the removal of that organ, that is ictomy. Okay, now see here, tonsillectomy, appendectomy, cholecystectomy and nephrectomy. What do you mean by this ectomy? So see, if tonsillectomy is there, means, so this is the surgical procedure only. Here what you are going to do, you are going to remove the tonsil completely. You are going to remove the tonsil from the body. Okay, so appendectomy, so you are going to remove the, what you are going to remove? Appendix you are going to remove, so you are going to remove the appendix from your body. Okay, so these are all the surgical terminology. So if you are going to remove the appendix, so this is completely only. Okay, you are cutting and removing that appendix, so that is the appendectomy. Cholecystectomy, you are going to remove the gallbladder and the its duct, so that is the cholecystectomy. Okay, so nephrectomy, you are going to remove the kidney. So this is the terminology for removal of kidney. So completely from the body you are going to remove out. Okay, you are taking out from the body. Now near there is the next suffix, that is otomy. Okay, if otomy is there, means what is that? See, otomy means first you are going to open the hollow organ. Okay, by surgical procedure you are going to open that. Again after that you are going to close that by suture. Okay, means this is the first you are going to open and then finally closing the hollow organ. Hollow organ means the organ having the cavity inside. Okay, if you are going to cut, first you are going to open, then you are going to close that organ. Means that procedure is the, that is the, that is denoted by the suffix otomy. Okay, if otomy is there, means that is the procedure where you are going to open the organ, then you are going to close that organ. Okay, so that is the otomy. So see here, laparotomy. So means, see, this is the, you are going to open the abdominal cavity, then you are going to close that after, okay, intervention. So hysterectomy means you are going to open the uterus and you are going to close. See, during the cesarean section, what you will do? See, you will open the uterus and you will remove the baby. After removal of baby, you are going to close that, isn't it? So that is the hysterectomy. First you will open, after the procedure is completed, you will going to close. So laparotomy, that is the opening of abdominal cavity and closing. Hysterectomy, opening of uterine cavity, then closing that, means by stitching or suturing. Then cystectomy, that you are going to open the urinary bladder and then after completion of their procedure, you are going to close that. So opening and closing the hollow organ, that means otomy. The suffix otomy denotes the opening and the closing of the hollow organ. Okay. Ectomy means completely remove. Removal, remove out from the body. Just you are removed from the body. Okay. And you are not going to put it back again. You will just remove and keep outside. That is the ectomy. Suffix ectomy. That is for complete removal. Otomy, that means first you are going to open the cavity, then again you are going to close that cavity. Okay, that is the whole organ. Okay, like stomach you may open and close, like uterus you may open and close, abdominal cavity you may open and close. So the suffix otomy denote that. So next there is the suffix ostomy. Only S difference is there. See, otomy and ostomy. Can you see? Otomy and ostomy. Can you see? So if there is the ostomy suffix is there, just you are going to open that and you are not going to close it again. So the just you are going to open the hollow organ and you will leave it open. You are not going to close. So that is the ostomy. So cystostomy, colostomy, tracheostomy. Okay. So opening of the urinary bladder. Just you will keep it open and leave. So that procedure is the cystostomy. If you are going to open the colon, that is large intestine, that is the colostomy. Have you seen that someone carrying the stool bag on the side? So they will do the colostomy and they will pour the stool in the bag. So they will keep the colon open only. Colon means large intestine. Okay. So tracheostomy, have you seen that they are the tracheostomy tube, they are going to insert from the trachea, from here neck region. So they will first open the trachea, then tube they will insert, and they will keep that open only. So that is the tracheostomy. Okay. So first open and leave it open. The hollow muscular organ, that is the term ostomy or suffix ostomy denote that. Okay. If there is the suffix ostomy at the end of the word, means that means that you keep open the hollow organ and leave it open. You don't close that. If otomy is there, first you will open. After completion of the surgical procedure, you are going to again close that by the stitches or sutures. So that is the otomy. Now next is the suffix oma. If oma suffix is there at the end, means that denotes the tumor. Okay, tumor growth, abnormal growth. So lipoma, osteoma, carcinoma, they all denotes the tumor. Okay, carcinoma, tumor of the epithelial lining. Okay, so osteoma, tumor of the osteophyte, that is the bone. Lipoma, the tumor of lipid cells. Okay, fatty layer. So oma means tumor. If oma is in the end, means that denotes the tumor. Okay. Then we'll go for the next slide. So here are the other terminology. See, inflammation. So inflammation you have already known, I think so. So inflammation, this is the protective response against the certain injury to the tissue. If any injury to the tissue is there or any cut is there in the tissue, means there is the inflammation will occur. That inflammation, that is the protective response only. Okay, are you getting? So see, if any injury is there, inflammation will occur. So this is the protective response against certain injury, and this inflammation is initiated by any physical, chemical or biological means. Okay, so if you in inflammation you will see the some cardinal features. Okay, you know that thing. So if inflammation is there, you will see the edema, you will see redness, you will see, isn't it? Redness, edema or swelling. Swelling, there is the increase in temperature. There is the increase in temperature. Or warmness is there. Then you will see the pain in that part. Then loss of function. These five are the cardinal features of the inflammation. So if any injury in this region is there, then what will happen? You will feel pain, isn't it? Pain. If then you will feel the red color around here. Okay. So redness you will see, isn't it? If any injury is there, pain is there. Then around this region there is the redness you will see, and you will also see the slightly swelling you will see. Then you will see the there is the rise in temperature in this region. Means you will see some warmness you will feel, and even you will see the loss of function of this region. There will be the loss of function of this region. Okay, where there is the inflammation, you will see these five features in that region. Okay, are you getting? Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so redness, swelling, warmness, that is the increase in temperature in that particular region. And next is the pain and loss of function. Okay, so they are the cardinal features for the five cardinal features for the inflammation. So inflammation is the protective tissue response against the sudden injury or injury. Okay, now next terminology is the edema. The edema denotes the swelling. Okay, edema means swelling. Okay, now next is the thrombosis. Thrombosis, see, so if there is the coagulation of blood inside the vessels, that is thrombosis. So intravascular coagulation of the blood. Are you getting this? Intravascular coagulation. So what will happen? Blood clot will form inside the vessels. That is the thrombosis. So what will happen here? Blood clot. So this terminology, so thrombosis means this, okay, intravascular coagulation of the blood. Are you getting? Then next is the embolism. So embolism means, see, this thrombosis, this, it will not move, okay, in the fixed part it will occlude the vessels, okay. So this is not moving, this clot is fixed at the particular side and it will block the blood flow, okay. It is fixed or it will block the blood flow, okay, or it is prevent the better to say obstruct, okay, it obstruct the blood flow, okay, prevent means different, right here obstruct, it obstruct the blood flow, okay, don't write prevent here, okay, prevent, the word is different. So see, it is the blood clot only, but this blood clot is fixed, it is not moving in the vessels, it will fix in the wall of the vessels and it will obstruct the blood flow or prevent the blood flow, okay. Are you getting this? Just I will draw here one picture, okay, got it. Now see here, suppose this is the, okay, this is the vessel, okay, it should be red color, okay. So this is the blood vessels, okay. Now see here, lumen is there. Now see, your thrombosis is like this. So thrombosis is like this, see, this is the clotting of blood. Now what will happen? See, if it blood is flowing from this direction, it will prevent the blood flow, isn't it? But it is fixed here. This clot of blood, it is not moving in moving in the lumen of the vessels. It is not moving. It is fixed, and it prevents the blood flow. This is the thrombosis. Now embolism, it is slightly different. Now see here. So if clot of blood is moving, that is embolism. Okay, now see in this next picture here. So this is the lumen, okay. Now if there is the blood clot that is freely moving, it is not attached in the wall and it is not fixed and it is moving along with the blood, means that is the embolism, okay. Are you getting? Now see here, blood flow is here. Now along with the blood it is moving. So this is the embolism. Are you getting? So this is about the, so this is the difference between the thrombosis and embolism. So if clot of blood is moving along with the blood, it may move anywhere. So this is the embolism. Thrombosis means coagulation, intravascular coagulation of the blood, and the blood clot is fixed at the wall, fixed in the wall, and thus it will obstruct the blood flow. But embolism, it is the piece of the clot only. This is the blood clot only, but this blood clot is moving with the blood. So this is the embolism. So you may heard about the pulmonary embolism. Okay. So while reading the pathology, you will listen this thing, embolism and thrombosis. Okay. So if blood clot inside the vessels and it is fixed and it is obstructing the blood flow, that is the thrombosis. And if the clot of blood is moving along the current of the blood, that is the embolism. So see, now this vessel is large, isn't it? So it is moving easily. If vessel is smaller than this, it will again obstruct the blood flow, isn't it? Okay. So this is the embolism. So next terminology, that is the hemorrhage. What is hemorrhage? Hemorrhage means bleeding. Okay. So hemorrhage denotes the bleeding. So bleeding, hemorrhage. So the bleeding, the terminology for bleeding, that is the hemorrhage. So hemorrhage, there may be the external hemorrhage or internal hemorrhage. Okay, if blood is visible outside the skin surface, that is the external. If bleeding is inside the body cavity, that is inside the organ, that is the internal hemorrhage. Okay, so thus it denotes the bleeding. Okay, so it may be external. Okay, so hemorrhage may be external hemorrhage or internal hemorrhage. Okay, now next terminology, this is the epistaxis. What is epistaxis? If bleeding is from nasal cavity or nose, that is epistaxis. Okay, this is again the bleeding, but this bleeding is from the nose. Okay, so this is the nasal bleeding. So it may be again anterior or posterior epistaxis. So nasal bleeding. So if blood is coming from this, see from here, if blood is coming from the external near or opening, external nasal orifice, then this is the anterior. If blood is coming, it is not coming from front, but it will go inside your mouth. Okay. That is the internal, posterior nasal bleeding. Now next terminology, that is the puberty. Puberty, this is the age actually, okay? Puberty denotes the time period in male and female. In this time period, there is the development of secondary sexual character, okay? So this is known as puberty, okay? So time period at which there is the development of secondary sexual characters in case of male and female. So for the puberty is for female, that is in between 12 to 15, and for boy, that is 13 to 16 years. Okay, just you remember this. So it is the time period when there is the development of secondary sexual characters. Okay. Okay, up to here. So that is the puberty. Okay, this is the age only. So at which there is the development of secondary sexual features or characters in male and female. So this is the time period of development of the secondary sexual character in the case of female. This 13 to 16 year, that is for boy. So this is the puberty age. Okay. Now this next one is the symptoms. Symptoms actually, see, if disease is there, say you will go to the doctor, isn't it? Isn't it? Then what you will tell to you? What you will tell to the doctor? You will tell something about the disease, isn't it? So that thing, what you are going to tell to the doctor, that is symptoms only. So this is a subjective complaint of the patient regarding the disease. Okay. So symptoms means this is the subjective complaint. Means you are going to complain yourself, isn't it? So if you have got one disease, okay. Now you are going to doctor and you are not knowing about that disease. Then what you will tell to that doctor about that disease? You will tell like, there is fever for me, there is cough for me, there is chest pain for me, you will tell, isn't it? So this complaint about your disease to the doctor, that is symptoms. So this is the subjective complaint of patient. So patient only is going to complain, isn't it? Or if Patient is very little or its children, their parents are going to complain, isn't it? So that is the symptoms. Okay, so this is the subjective patient regarding disease. Okay, or patient regarding disease or any disease. Okay, so this is the symptoms. So symptoms means that is the it is the complaint of patient. Complaint of. So this is the complaint only, isn't it? Complaint of patient regarding the disease. So this is symptom. Then what is sign? So sign. So this is the objective finding. Finding of the doctor regarding disease. Okay, are you getting? So see, now see, you will tell, see, you have got some disease and you went to the doctor. Now you will tell, doctor, I have got a abdominal pain. Okay, you are going to tell there is the abdominal pain. Now what doctor will do? He will do examination on you. Okay, he will palpate your abdomen. Okay, while palpating, if you feel sudden pain, okay, while palpating by the hand, you will the pain may be increased. Okay, isn't it? The pain may increase, isn't it? So that increase in pain, that is tenderness. Now tenderness is the finding of doctor. See, you are complaining, I have got a pain. Now doctor will do examination, and if he find the increase in pain while palpating, so that is the tenderness. So now tenderness is the sign. Are you getting? So you are not going to complain about that I have got a tender abdomen. You are not going to complain. You are going to complain that I have got a abdominal pain. Okay, while doing the examination by the doctor, if he find the increase in the pain while examining or while palpating, okay, that is the tenderness. So pain is the symptoms and tenderness is the sign. Are you getting? I'm just giving one example. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then next is the now sign and symptoms difference. You can tell, no? So objectives is the finding of doctor. Finding of. In short, you can write this is the finding of doctor. Okay. So this is the finding of doctor. This is the complaint of patient regarding the disease. Okay. Now the next is the diagnosis. What is the diagnosis? What may be the diagnosis? So see, diagnosis. See, it is the identification or determination of nature of disease. Okay. For example, I'll give one example. See, if you went to the doctor, okay, see, you will tell that I have got a fever, I have got a abdominal pain, okay, so I have got a like sweating, okay, like that you will tell. That is the symptoms. Okay, now doctor will do the examination and you will find the tenderness and you will find put the thermometer and see the increase in temperature. Okay, how much temperature is increased, you will find. Then finally, what will say? He will tell the name of disease, isn't it? So, like that, you have got a typhoid, or you have got a pneumonia, or you have got a this disease, isn't it? So, diagnosis is that. So, identification of disease or determination of the nature of disease. Okay, from the sign and symptoms. Okay, that is the diagnosis. Diagnosis means identification of the disease or determination of nature of disease. That is the diagnosis.